Anthropic recently released prompt caching, which allows you to have up to 90% cost reduction and latency reduction of up to 85% for their flagship models Claude 3.5 Sonnet, Opus, and Haiku. Research community is calling this as a rack killer because of the cost reduction as well as the latency reduction, even for long form context. One of the major challenges in large language models is the operational cost due to the computational heavy operations, which also leads to increase in the latency for generating the text output. With prompt caching, you are essentially able to save that computation time, and hence they improve the latency. But how does prompt caching really work inside LLMs? In this video, I'm going to explain you. What Anthropic mentions is that you can use prompt caching for conversational agents, coding assistants, large document processing, detailed instruction sets, agentic search and tools, as well as talking to books and papers. What they show in a comparison table is a chat with a book of 100,000 tokens that are cached. So without caching, the latency is 11.5 seconds, whereas latency with caching is only 2.4 seconds, which is a 79% reduction. And hence, the cost reduction is also around 90%. Similarly, for multi-turn conversations with 10-turn conversations with a long system prompt, you're able to save up to 75% in terms of latency and 53% in terms of cost. But how does prompt caching actually work? Let's find out. Now imagine that for your large language model, you give the following sequence as an input, which is my favorite fruit is, and you want the LLM to generate the next token. And so what happens is that your large language model creates embeddings for these tokens, and these embeddings are then passed within the large language model attention modules. So you pass your embedding for my as a word into your large language model, it goes through your attention layers and it works as a next word prediction even for your input words. So in this case, ideally the model should have predicted favorite, and so there will be embeddings for the complete vocabulary in which favorite should have come out as a top selected word. So then you actually go about and feed that as an input, and then you continue this process where your favorite embedding also goes out. And in this case, what it actually does is it looks at the previously created attention weights as well to actually generate the final output. And so in this case, it would then have predicted fruit. And for fruit also, it looks at the previous two tokens, and then is again looks at the previous tokens as well as its current own embedding. And it would actually give you the final output, let's say as orange. And then this process gets repeated for the each and every word that is to be generated from there on. Now, as you can see, a very obvious problem here is that for each word, even though it was in the input prompt, we have to compute these embeddings and then go about computing it for each and every word for previously looked at tokens. And then only we can generate the final word orange. But what if for the input, instead of computing these tokens and embeddings every time, you were to save these weights into a database? So imagine that these weights are actually a 3x4 embedding matrix. And so this 3x4 embedding matrix is stored in a database, which essentially represents my favorite fruit is as the cached version when it has been passed to the transformer. So when the same instruction is seen again, instead of computing these again, we can simply load it from the database and initialize the transformer and ask it to only generate the final word, which is orange in this case. This will save you both time because you don't have to make these computations for each and every token, as well as it will save you cost because running LLMs requires GPUs. So now imagine if you had a very long input prompt such as a book or a very long conversation chat or a very long system prompt, and you were to save that as a cache in your database, and when required you just simply load the database, you will be actually saving a lot of time and cost for that complete book to be loaded into the model and then getting answers out of it. So this is the whole premise of prompt caching, where you actually keep a cache of strings or system prompts that you know will be very recurring, and then you are able to directly generate the output tokens instead of recomputing the input tokens as well. So as you can see from the developer documentation of Anthropic, the cache in this case has a lifetime of about 5 minutes. So any system prompts that have been given in the past 5 minutes are going to get cached, and that can be used to save computation and latency. And they have also given certain examples in the documentation, such as large context caching, in which, as per the code, they are able to cache a full text of complex legal agreement. So this is where you would have a 50-page, let's say a very long book or a 50-page legal document. And what you can define is a cache control, which is a type ephemeral. So using this, Anthropic understands that this part of the prompt should be cached, and it goes ahead and caches it for the next 5 minutes. So the first time it actually takes some time to load and create this computation that we were showing earlier. But once it has been computed and stored into the ephemeral, you can then compute and get the subsequent answers very fast. So in this case, when a user question comes in, it directly has to generate and compute only for those new tokens and not for the complete 50-page legal document. Similarly, they also show how you can cache tools, in which case you are able to directly keep many different tools as in the cache control itself, and then you can directly run these agentic workflows and get faster outputs. And they also show you can do a multi-turn conversation caching, in which imagine if the user has a very long chat going on. Instead of recomputing the tokens for every new message that comes into the long chat, you can actually cache each and every message into the chat so far, so that only the new tokens are to be generated when a new request comes in. So that is about prompt caching. I hope you had learned something new. If you enjoy such kind of content, make sure to like this video and subscribe to the channel. Until next time, this is Anubhav. Bye-bye.